Welcome into another edition of Berg is the Word. My name is Mark Bergin, and the Chicago Bears fall to the Los Angeles Chargers 17-16. Bears kicker Eddy Piñeiro misses a 41-yard field goal at the end of regulation, and the Chargers hang on to win the football game. The Bears fall below 500. I'm going to break this game down for you really quickly. It came down to the final field goal. 41 yards. The Bears had about 43 seconds left on the clock, and head coach Matt Nagy decided to knee the ball and run the clock down. And everyone's going to be second-guessing Nagy all week about whether or not the Bears should have tried to run the ball or run another play to get closer for a closer field goal kick. Piñeiro missed two field goals today. He missed the 41-yarder at the end of regulation. He missed a 33-yard field goal earlier in the game. It's also worth noting that the Chargers kicker also missed a field goal in today's game. So there were multiple missed field goal attempts, but this game might have very well knocked the Bears out of playoff contention, considering how well Minnesota and Green Bay has played thus far in the NFC North. We'll see what happens tonight on Sunday Night Football when the Packers take on the Chiefs. Packers leading the division right now. But this game comes back to, you know, when Piñeiro makes the field goal against Denver, a 53-yard game winner, he misses the 41-yarder at home today at Soldier Field, and it costs Chicago the game. Going back to that Denver game, too, if not for that roughing the passer penalty on Bradley Chubb against Mitchell Trubisky, Bears wouldn't have won that game. So honestly, the Bears kind of stole one in Denver earlier this year. This is kind of karma to me that they lose on a 41-yard field goal. I want to know what questions you have about today's game. If you question Matt Nagy or you question the play of Mitchell Trubisky, kind of who you think was the scapegoat, but in a must-have do-or-die situation where the field goal wins it, a 41-yarder, if you're an NFL kicker, you've got to be able to make the field goal. And that was something that the Bears experienced a year ago with Cody Parkey. That's why they got rid of Cody Parkey after his troubles, not just in the playoff game against Philadelphia, but all throughout the regular season. I don't know if you remember that game last year against Minnesota where Parkey hit the upright four times, which statistically is probably one of the biggest anomalies in all of sports. But Chicago not getting it done today, and Trubisky struggled. The Bears were able to get the ground game going, and they controlled the clock for 38 minutes in today's game. I'm going to read through some stats that kind of stuck out to me. But if you do have questions, feel free to reach out. Trubisky was 23 of 35, 253 yards passing, no touchdowns. He had an interception, was sacked four times, and had a fumble. The turnovers were key. The Chargers won the turnover battle. Chargers only turned it over once in today's game. But when, you know, push comes to shove, Trubisky got the Bears into the field goal position, or into field goal position. A 41-yarder, if you're an NFL kicker, you've got to be able to make that. And I don't know what the stats are from that specific range, but if you have a 41-yard field goal with your kicker to win the game, you probably feel pretty good that your kicker is going to be able to make it. But Piñeiro falls short, and there's going to be a lot of people questioning Matt Nagy's decision to run the time down and not to try to maybe hand the ball to David Montgomery, who had his first career game with more than 100 yards rushing on the ground. Montgomery, 27 carries, 135 yards rushing, and a touchdown on the ground. He had a long 55-yard run in today's game, too. I thought he played really, really well. And again, the Bears controlled the clock in this one, and you thought that that might wear down the Chargers' defense. The Bears had the football today for 38 minutes in today's game. Total yardage for both teams, too. The Chargers only had 231 yards, and the Bears had 388. So the secret to beating the Bears is if you're a team that can score 20 or more points, you're going to beat Chicago. You're going to beat the Bears because this offense is one of the worst in the NFL, if not the very worst. Going into today's game, I've got a stat that will blow your mind. Going into today's game, the Bears were the only NFL team without a game of at least 300 yards, 300 total yards, offensive yards. The Bears were the only team that hadn't had a game with at least 300 total yards. Again, they finished with 388 today. The Chargers only had 231 yards. this Bears defense, and this is really what the big issue is with this Bears team. They are spoiling what could be a historically good and potentially great defense because the Bears offense isn't even adequate. You've got Khalil Mack, Leonard Floyd, Danny Trevathan, you know, guys in the secondary, Eddie Jackson, Kyle Fuller, who had an interception, Clinton Dix. You got playmakers all throughout this defense. Roquan Smith, you got playmakers all throughout this defense. And the offense, if the offense is even adequate, the defense more often than not will be able to carry this team. But the Bears offense falls short yet again. Really, if you think about it, if you were an NFL team and you knew that your defense would be able to hold the opposing team's offense to fewer than 20 points, you're probably going to win more games than you lose. It's that simple. But if you're an NFL team and you can score more than 20 on the Bears, you're probably winning because this Bears offense is, it just stinks. It has absolutely been abysmal. But at least you saw the Bears had somewhat of a strategy today, trying to control the clock, trying to get the running game going, and they did some of those things. And Trubisky put his team in a position to win the football game at the end. Sometimes the ball doesn't bounce your way. And it happened to work out for the Bears earlier this year in Denver. Again, I'll go back to the roughing the passing penalty on Chubb, Bradley Chubb, back in the Denver game. It kept the Bears' drive alive, and Piñeiro was able to hit a 53-yard game winner in that game. And today, Piñeiro missing the 41-yard field goal at regulation, and it cost the Bears. And again, that was his second missed field goal of the game, which a lot of people are going to overlook. Now, I will say this too. One other key takeaway I had from this game was the decision at the end of the first half to try to run the football with Montgomery in the red zone. The Bears had problems in the red zone today, executing and scoring touchdowns. They had a lot of field goals in the red zone, but the decision at the end of the half to run the football without any timeouts, and the Bears, you know, guys were kind of stuck on the ground and it ran so much time off to where Trubisky had to spike it and the Bears had to kick a field goal to take a 9-7 lead in at halftime. You could question that as well of, you know, trusting your quarterback in that situation of throwing the ball. And if it's an incomplete, at least you get, you know, one more down, to one more crack at the end zone to try to score. So you could question Matt Nagy about that decision at the end of the first half. You could also question his decision at the end of the game when the Bears are about 41 yards out, not to try to get closer to kick a game-winning field goal. But the hindsight is 20-20. You know, if the Bears do get 5 yards closer, or if Piñeiro actually makes the field goal at the end of regulation, are we even questioning that decision? Really, what I would want to know, I'm a data guy, I'm a stats guy. I don't just make a knee-jerk decision one way or another. What I would want to know is, what is the statistical probability from 41 yards? Say you get another 5 yards from 36 or 35 yards. Do your odds really improve that greatly? And is the risk of a fumble or a turnover greater than trusting your kicker to make a 41-yard field goal at the end of regulation? These are the questions that I would have. And what I would want to know is, what do the stats and data show? Because you're going to see a lot of stuff this week about reaction to this game, questioning Nagy, questioning Trubisky, questioning a lot of the Bears' decision-making in this game. But are they questioning it because the result wasn't what you wanted at the end with the Piñeiro missed field goal? Or is it what data, stats, and information actually show you? And that's the question I would offer to fans to ask to themselves. And I'm sure the data is out there that might prove, hey, if the Bears do get 5 extra yards, and maybe the field goal goes in that Piñeiro kicks, if he has an extra 5 yards, maybe the ball hooks in and the Bears celebrate today, and maybe they would have won. But instead, Chargers win 17-16. My name is Mark Bergin. Again, this is another edition of Bergin's the Word. Please feel free to share this to people on your newsfeed. Feel free to subscribe as well. I'm going to go ahead and sign off here. I will be doing a breakdown of the Buccaneers-Titans game shortly after this, so stay tuned for that. Take care. Happy football, everyone, and I'll see you next time. So long, everyone.